I thought I'd do a pilling the cat video since I need to give Tiny Bear a pill. I don't give my kitties pills very often, so this is an opportunity to. If the kitty is amenable to the pill pockets, which I think we've done videos on before, then that is a great way to do it. But if they won't take the pill pockets, then you're going to have to pill them. Nugget gets her pills. She gets a daily pill, and she takes them in the pill pockets just fine. This pill for Tiny Bear is very bitter. So how to get the kitty to take this pill without a huge struggle? I've tried regular pill guns and didn't care that much for them. When I saw this one, I thought, well, now that's rather clever. Normally, you should never give a pill without some kind of a liquid chaser to help wash it down. So generally, I'm stuffing the pill down the cat's throat with a syringe stuck in my mouth. Not the kind of syringe with a needle, but the kind that you can just put some fluid in so that I can quickly squirt them in the mouth as a chaser. And that works, but it's a little cumbersome. So I saw these pill guns here, which are really very clever because you can pull the liquid up in it, and you can put the pill in the end, and then when you squirt it in the cat's mouth, the pill shoots out the end along with the fluid right behind it. The other little trick that I came upon, where else? The internet. If you have a pill that is particularly bitter, you can encapsulate it in empty pill pockets. These are the smallest sizes. These are kind of like wire gauges. The larger number means the smaller size. So this is size 5. This is the smallest pill capsules that you can buy. You can buy them in small quantity bags like this on Amazon. And then the next size up is also small enough for a cat. This is size 4. For Tiny Bear's pill, I could fit it in the size 5, so that's what we're going to use. For the fluid, you can just use plain water, but if you have tuna fish, and it's the tuna fish water, you just squeeze it out. I've been saving it in the ice cube trays, freezing little cubes of it just for this purpose. So first I'm going to draw in some fluid of tuna fish juice. You don't want too much, you don't want to choke them. But just a little bit, about like that. You're going to want to wipe off the end of it. You don't want this pill getting soggy, or the capsule getting soggy. I have the capsules pre-made up here with the medication inside. You can crush the pill if you need to, or you can just put the pill in whole if it will fit into the little capsule. And then you stick the capsule in the end. I'm going to do that when we go get the cat. Okay, here we are again. We got Tiny Bear in hand, and as usual, I almost find it always easiest to give kitties their medications or various treatments tucked up back up between my legs. Now we've got our syringe here, and it's got the little fluid in it. Kalahari, go away. And I'm going to stick the pill in. Kalahari, they're not going to be able to see anything. Go, 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 go. Usually this is the kind of thing you do without, usually lock the other cats out. It's way too distracting. Go away now. Okay. Or I lose my cat. I'll give you a pill. Yes, I will. Okay, we've got the pill in the end, close to the plunger. And I've got it arranged. Come on, Kalahari, stop this. Okay. Pull the kitty's head back, not too far back because you don't want to choke around it, but just back. She'll be back normally. Yeah, just get it open in there. Yeah, you got it, good girl. And then just pop it in. Tiny Bear's got her pill. In spite of Kalahari.